Good morning, children. It's another Sunday, and today we'll look at another part of the armor of God that the Bible teaches us about. I brought some special shoes today, some wooden shoes. Yes, they're made completely of wood, and they're clogs, and I'm sure you've seen them before. And in my country, in the Netherlands, we call them klompen. Now you might think, are they very comfortable? Well, many farmers in the Netherlands still wear them. And yes, they are comfortable because they keep his feet cool in the summer and warm in the winter. And also, it helps him not to slip because it makes him stand firm on the land. Talking about shoes, these are shoes of a rugby player. A rugby player has special shoes with cleats at the bottom. Now these cleats, they dig into the ground so that he also stands firm and he will not slip when the ball comes or when he is in a scrum or when he has to throw the ball. He'll be ready to play that game because of the cleats, because of the special shoes. And we'll talk about special shoes today. But first I want to read you a verse about beautiful feet. When, according to the Bible, are our feet beautiful? It says how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. Now let's take a look at the armor the way we did last week. Remember how last week we looked at the helmet of salvation. Yes, the helmet of salvation that protects us from Satan's lies. Now today, we will look at the shoes. Imagine a Roman soldier that puts on his armor, but forgets his shoes. A barefoot soldier. How silly would that be? And would he be ready to fight? Well, he wouldn't be able to march for long distances or to even fight the enemy. He might slip. His feet would get hurt from the rocks and the stones that were on the ground. He would not be ready. And the piece of the armor that we talk about, that we put on, that you put on by praying, are the shoes of the readiness of the gospel that comes from the gospel of peace. Let me tell you about this man who was ready to bring the good news. You know, that's another word for gospel, means good news. His name was Philip. And Philip had been preaching the gospel, the good news, in the villages and the cities of Samaria. Many, many people had come to listen to him, and many people believed in the Lord Jesus. Then an angel of the Lord came to Philip and said, "Philip, I want you to go to Gaza." Now that was about 100 kilometers away. And actually Gaza was a deserted place. Hardly anybody lived there. And you look here in the north, this is where Samaria is. And then here in the south, this is where Gaza is. Why would Philip have to go to that place where there were hardly any people? I'm sure he will have wondered about that. Why does God want me to go there? And Satan was trying to discourage him from going there by that he got these thoughts of why. But what do you think? Was he ready? I already said it. Philip was ready that wherever he had to go, whatever God told him to do, he was ready and he would obey because he had put on those shoes of the readiness of the gospel of peace. And if you are God's child, he also wants you to put on those shoes of the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace so that you're ready to tell your friends. Now, maybe in this time you talk to your friends a lot on WhatsApp or through Hangouts or maybe on Facebook. And sometimes that is an easier way to maybe say something about your faith in Jesus. But what? When you go back to school, will you be ready? Will you be ready to tell your friends about Jesus? Well, Philip for sure was ready to go. And he went on this trip, even though he did not know what to expect, but he obeyed God. He was wearing those shoes. The same time somebody else traveled, he came from a faraway country, from the country of Ethiopia. As you know, that's in the north of Africa. He traveled from Ethiopia up to Jerusalem. Now, Jerusalem is more or less in between Samaria and Gaza. This man was a very important man. We don't know his name. The Bible doesn't tell us what his name was. But he was the treasurer for the queen of Ethiopia. Why did he go to Jerusalem? To worship. He wanted to worship. He wanted to find the one and only true God. He was looking for peace. But he didn't know about the problem that was in his heart, in his life. Do you know about that problem? The problem of sin. You know, the Bible tells us something about sin, many things about sin, but I want to read one verse for you. It says, "There is not a righteous man on earth who does what is right and never sins." The Bible tells us all have sinned. We are born, you are also born with a sinful nature. And that means you do not belong to God. You're separated from Him forever. And that is a problem in your heart, just as it was a problem in the heart of this man from Ethiopia. So he went all the way to Jerusalem. But you know what? No, it seems no one shared with him about the love of God and about the peace of God. People in Jerusalem knew about Jesus who had died, but how many really had believed? No one had shared with this man. So I'm sure he was sad and he was discouraged as he traveled back to Ethiopia, to his country. But he had bought something in Jerusalem, and this was a scroll with a piece of scripture on it. And so as he was going back on his chariot, he was reading from this scroll. But it was like reading mystery. He didn't understand what he was reading. Then, while he was driving, Philip arrived also in the deserted place of Gaza. And Philip was looking across the desert, and he was shielding his eyes from the bright sun. And what did he see there? A chariot. And the Spirit told him, "Go there, go to that chariot." And the Bible tells us he ran towards it. How excited he must have been. He was ready. And he had put on his shoes, and he was ready to go and bring the gospel. And there he came near the chariot, and he heard how this man, this Ethiopian man, was reading from this scroll. Because in that time, if you would read, you would read out loud. So Philip could ask him, he said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" "Well, how could I?" said the Ethiopian, "if no one explains it to me." So what an opportunity for Philip. He had been ready. And now God brought him here to tell about the love of God. And also, this is part of what I want to tell you, that God loves you so much. He loves you so much that He gave His Son, the Lord Jesus, for you to die on the cross. And actually, the Ethiopian was reading from the book of Isaiah, and he was reading about the lamb that was brought to be slaughtered. And it really speaks about the Lord Jesus. Like when Jesus, when he was arrested, you know, and when he was put on the cross, and people mocked him and they spit at him and they said nasty things to him, but he kept his mouth shut. He didn't say a thing. This was God's love that he sent his son to die on the cross also for you. If you do not know about that peace of God, if you do not know that your sins are forgiven, then today I tell you, you may know that Jesus died on the cross also to take the punishment for you and me, so that if you believe, you can also belong to God forever and know that peace. And as Philip was explaining the Ethiopian about this scripture, he could tell the Ethiopian this good news of God's love. And the Ethiopian, when they then passed with the chariot, there was water on the roadside. And the Ethiopian said, well, why can I not be baptized now? He had understood that he had a problem of sin in his life. He needed God's forgiveness to find God's peace. And he wanted to be baptized so that he could show that he believed in Jesus. Well, Philip said, you must believe. And the Ethiopian said, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. So they stopped the chariot, they got off, and Philip baptized the Ethiopian in the water right then and there, at that very moment. And then something curious happened, because right after that, Philip disappeared. The Bible tells us he wasn't there anymore. But the Ethiopian's heart was filled with peace, and he was full of joy about what had just happened. He had come to believe in the Lord Jesus. He had found the Savior, and he traveled back to his own country, and I'm sure to tell others about Jesus. Now, what about you? Do you know that peace? And I tell you, if you don't know that peace, then look in your heart. And if you know there's sin in your heart, then you may know Jesus died for you as well. And after 3 days, as we know, he rose from the grave and he's alive today. Now, but if you know him, if you know you have that peace, then as part of putting on the armor of God, put on those shoes of the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. Because when you have peace with God, then you will be ready to tell others about that wonderful good news about Jesus. Let us pray for a moment. We thank you, Father, that you make us ready to go tell others about your Son, the Lord Jesus. And we thank you for this amazing peace that is in our hearts because we are forgiven, we have eternal life, we may belong to you, we are safe and protected. So I pray, help each one of us to put on the armor and to put on those shoes to be ready to preach the good news, to tell the good news. And I pray for that child that doesn't know you yet, that you touch and open his heart and his eyes to see you, to know your love. Thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you're in grade 7, I want to wish you good luck when you go back to school tomorrow. And I hope to see you again next Sunday. And bye-bye.